So I actually went to study in the US, and when I was in Stephens, I should actually say I was pretty interested in theater, and you know, doing stuff as a wanted to do stuff as a theater actor and theater director, but my medium was really English, and you know, there wasn't much scope for doing stuff then. So I decided to actually do something in filmmaking, and I didn't really know what documentary was. But I went to this school at UPenn, the Annenberg School for Communication, and took a documentary filmmaking class and really fell in love with it. So that's sort of how I eventually get here. Yeah, you know, I mean, we used to work with 16mm, and my first couple of film projects were 16mm. My student film at UPenn was also 16mm. It was a little intimidating, frankly, to work with film, and you specialized in certain things then. I mean, for instance, I frankly began by developing a fear of camera because, you know, just spooling film and things like that, I wasn't really comfortable with that. But on the other hand, I was fairly comfortable editing right from the beginning. I mean, well, it was very specialized. And I think the change in technology has meant two things. One, it's meant that I think I certainly feel sometimes I'm not as careful with my shot taking because footage, I mean, video is so cheap, you can just keep shooting. Whereas, for instance, we in The Boy in the Branch, which was shot in 16mm, we really planned our shots and our takes and decided when we would use picture and when we would have to use just sound because tape, you know, film stock is very expensive. So the other thing, of course, is the which is wonderful is the incredible democratization, you know, that's happening, and anyone can pick up a camera now and make a film. And I've gradually learned to also get over my fear of camera, because I think today as a professional you have to do a little bit of everything, you know. So I've grudgingly picked up the camera myself. So yeah, I think the practice of documentary filmmaking has changed to some extent in terms of maybe nature of, you know, almost sometimes perhaps having to really plan your shots. But I'm all for the, you know, greater accessibility. You know, I think funding is just very difficult now. But I think funding was very difficult then, also. And I should say that I should add that you know, I was really one of the fortunate ones in terms of this project, because they commissioned three films out of, my understanding was they got over 1,000 proposals. You know. So it was just very, very competitive. It remains that way today. I mean, if you just even look at PSBT, the number of proposals they get and the number of commissioned films. I do think that what's happened here is that in India, certainly this, what I call the PSBT model of funding and distribution is, you know, has survived and is really the norm. So I think PSBT, for instance, despite the fact that they've commissioned some very, very good films, they don't realize that, you know, documentary is a medium that requires a little bit more time. It's not like news gathering. And so those budgets have just not expanded, you know, accordingly. I mean, so I just feel that filmmakers could have done that much more. But so, you know, it's very competitive in Europe and the US as well. There remain those few documentary grant foundations that everybody applies to. But, you know, with, I mean, I used to, have a really good track record in terms of my own applications, and now I find that, you know, every now and then the you know, the projects don't bite, or, I mean, or, you know, I can't sell them. So then you look for small little grants, and you just about get to make the film. And you know, I think you take on that much more yourself. You will do the editing yourself, you will, you know, part of the camera work yourself, so you sort of pull through. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm pretty interested in the realm of politics. Now, of course, anything you do in documentary, really, you can argue is political. You know, the kind of shot you choose and how you frame your subject, that is also, in some ways, people might argue, a political act. You know, because form is political. And but just talking specifically about the political realm, as in politics, I've always been interested in this and tried to use the documentary film as a medium to really interrogate certain issues. So primarily, I mean, these would be political organizations like So from the left and the right, I'm very interested in, you know, sort of documenting their stories, their organization, their ideology, but also how the common guy, the common worker, really functions within these organizations and what his or her role is, or the part that political mobilization plays, for instance. So I think that is something that is common to my work with the RSS, but also with left organizations, left-affiliated organizations like Jannatya Manch, to my recent work, which is on the Aam Aadmi Party, and it's on an Aam Aadmi Party election campaign. So just get very excited by, all things political, and using the documentary as a form to interrogate it. You know, documentary filmmaking is really allied, I feel, to ethnographic research, for instance. There are tremendous commonalities in terms of, you know, what the anthropologist does when he or she is doing fieldwork, to what you do as a documentary filmmaker. So I think it just lends itself very, very well to, documentation as a form of research. And there's another thing that I think increasingly perhaps, a lot of us are moving towards, which is that you don't necessarily now even have to think in terms of a finished film. You know, video documentation and using video as a tool for research can be ongoing. And, I'm sure you'll tell me more about this, but it sounds like your city's research, is an example of that. I mean, I have started one project which is set in Mumbai, which is on transformations of, public space, or transformations in public space. And, I made a presentation at the Lichtenberg-Kolleg in Germany, where I was a fellow, where I said, well, I can see myself doing this over 20 years. And people just kind of gasped, as, oh my God, we won't be around to see your work in 20 years' time. But the idea is you keep looking at the same subjects, so you keep looking at the same locations, and it's really for the long haul. And it's just a wonderful medium for preservation as well. So, yeah, I really see them, being very much an ally in terms of, doing ethnographic research. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we used to, I used to sometimes joke with my filmmaking buddies or, my colleagues, saying that, it's really the bane of your existence sometimes when you have this wonderful professor who comes and gives you lectures, but who just has no clue as to what goes into the making of a film. So, I think this is important. There is some wonderful theoretical writing on the documentary, but it somehow never seems to connect really with the actual practice. So I think one informs the other. So, it's very nice when you're, even talking about, say you're talking about direct cinema, or you're talking about cinema verte, you show the masters, you show the greats, whether it's, Frederick Wiseman or Penny Baker or Jean Roche, but then you're also able to show contemporary work, or maybe sometimes your own, films, or excerpts from your work, because that's always very useful for students to be able to, on a one-on-one, talk to you about the decisions you made. So, yeah, I think it really helps. And I would advise both, the filmmaker who actually, has not really looked at a body of cinema or, studied theory, to do a little bit of that. And then similarly advise the film theorist to, pick up a camera and go there and, make a film. So the courses I teach, I just finished teaching a course on documentary theory and production. And this actually is the one course that's offered by a center, which is the Center for Modern Indian Studies, which does not necessarily have to do with India, because it's just students choose local subjects and do their research in Göttingen, in Germany, and they make their films. So a very standard, film documentary, film analysis and production class. But I will be teaching a class on the politics of Hindutva. And I tend to use documentary film a lot in terms of, so there'll be lots of film screenings, and, then we'll have our readings, and we'll also read original texts by, Hindutva writers and RSS ideologues, but we'll also look at texts that are critical of the RSS, and look at a lot of films. I think primarily films that critique the Hindutva movement, but we also hope to show some films that are represent their viewpoint. And the other class I have taught is on Indian democracy and political documentary films. So that looks at, you know, different issues throughout the country. It could be the politics of communalism, it could be social movements, you know, issues of separatism and regionalism, but the primary text is the documentary film and how it looks at, analyzes, interrogates these issues.